Good morning, everyone, and welcome once again to Wacky Wednesday. When people go on a holiday, they come back with mementos, with gifts and souvenirs for their loved ones. When I go on a holiday, I come back with stories. Recently, I was on a holiday in Yosemite, one of the most biodiverse national parks of America. From there, from 8,000 feet above sea level, from the lovely Tulin Meadows, I bring you my story. As I grew up, I believed in fairies. I read a lot of Enid Blyton and I believed in enchanted forests. So when I went out, I peeped inside every flower. I looked inside every bluebell. I peeped behind a bush, hoping to find a fairy. But I didn't find any. Years later, quite recently, in Yosemite, I did discover my fairy. And this is a tale of this fairy. This fairy took us on a walk to expose us and introduce us to the wonders of the Tulin Meadows. Yes, as we walked, we met Mr. Pine. The fairy told us that there is a Mr. Pine flower and Mrs. Pine flower. And the wind, the mountain wind, who is their love messenger, carries the pollen from Mr. Pine flower to Mrs. Pine flower. When pollination happens, we have a pine cone. When the pine cone falls to the ground, Mrs. Squirrel nibbles at it, releases the pine seed, and we have more pine trees. Before we know, there is a pine forest. Do you know, a pine cone follows the same Fibonacci pattern that is found in a shell deep down in the sea? The same one that you see in the spiral galaxy up in outer space? Aren't we connected in a beautiful way? Yes, as we walked along the meadows, the fairy introduced us to different flower friends. Each one had a different and enchanting mechanism to welcome its love messenger, the bugs and the bees. There was this particular blue flower we met who had certain petals. So when the bees sat on it, the petals dipped down. And out came a spray of pollen, spraying the little bee. When the bee went from one flower to another, there was pollination. Isn't it a wondrous world we live in? The fairy made us listen to silence, such a rare commodity in our chaotic cities. He made us listen to the wind as it rustled among the grass. I met Rumex, the remedy that I use for dry cough in my patient. What an excitement it was to meet the Rumex flower. And then I realized Ranunculus, the remedy that I use for herpes, is also a beautiful flower. I was so excited to meet them. As we walked around, the fairy told us to be careful and walk mindfully. Because if we walk mindlessly in the meadows, we will trample on the grass and we will create a spider web of footpaths. When the rain comes, the water will lodge in these footpaths, will not seep in the meadows. Before you know, the meadows will start perishing. The grass flowers would die. Along with it would die the bugs and the bees, the birds, and then the trees. Before we know, we would have a desert right here, right now. Do we want that? No. We want to protect Gaia. We want to protect Mother Earth. So next time you go out in the meadows, be careful as you walk around hunting for butterflies, bees, and beautiful flowers. Please, walk mindfully. As we walked along, he showed us a big red tree struck by lightning. On it were little holes made by the woodpecker, and inside it lived some other birds. The woodpecker did not say, "Not fair. I made the hole, you live in." Nature lives on interdependency. Along the way, we met the spring, which gurgled from the center of Mother Earth. Out 8,000 feet above sea level. It brought in warm water tinged with a lot of minerals. Can anybody ever get low ferritin here? Because this water was rich in iron. It had a beautiful red color and yummy taste. Can you imagine? I even tasted it. And there beside the spring stood my fairy, pulled out a book and read a poem. Yes, I'm going to share a few lines from it. The whole poem I'll share at the end of the video. He must give himself over to chance, for they live beyond prediction. He must give himself over to patience, for they live beyond will. He must be led along the hill as if by prayer. Found, unfound, they breathe their light into the mind year after year. Yes, every year there is a poet summit here. Poetry will simply flow out of anybody who sits for a while among these enchanted meadows in this beautiful nature. Yes, my fairy is none other than Ranger Brian. He doesn't have wings. He doesn't have the long flowing hair like the fairies in Lord of the Rings. He wears a hat. He's a sturdy guy with salt and pepper beard. But he is on a mission to save Gaia. He is on a mission to help people understand the wonders of nature so that they would want to protect it. I salute every ranger for protecting the environment, for taking care of Gaia, for taking care of Mother Earth, preserving her treasures for future generations. Yes, we need such fairies, many, many such fairies. Do you know, Tulin Meadow was a land of snow. It had 6 glaciers, but today, unfortunately, because of the global warming, we have just 1 glacier remaining. Do you want to burn Mother Earth? No, we don't want to do that. So let's pray for all the rangers who fight harsh weather, who courageously face every difficulty so that they can take care of Mother Earth for us and for everybody. Thank you, Ranger Brian. Thank you, all the rangers of